Obama administration officials have praised Palestinian Authority President Mahmoud Abbas as someone with whom Israel can do business. Yet Abbas recently chose to do business with those committed to Israel's destruction. Abbas struck a deal with the terror group Hamas last month, making it part of a united Palestinian government. The move left some wondering whether Abbas's Palestinian Authority ever really wanted peace with Israel in the first place.
Peace doesn't have a chance because peace doesn't pay. Because anytime they want some income, all they've got to do is commit an act of terrorism.
In his book, Financing the Flames, Edwin Black details how the Palestinian Authority rewards terrorists who have killed Israelis.
As soon as a terrorist commits an act of terrorism against an innocent civilian in Israel, whether that's cutting the throat of a child or stabbing a man standing at a bus or blowing up a building, as soon as that man does that, he goes on a special salary from the Palestinian Authority under Palestinian law, a law known as the law of the prisoner.
The more Israelis killed, the bigger the financial reward.
He gets a graduated salary depending on how heinous the crime is. If he kills five people and gets 5 years, he gets one salary. If he kills double that number and gets double the sentence, he gets double the salary. And so this actually incentivizes the misery, mayhem, and carnage that the terrorists commit.
Black told CBN News this is a long-held policy. He spent time on the ground interviewing Israeli and Palestinian officials and found that the PA does not hide this Cash for Killers program.
There's an entire ministry called the Palestinian Ministry of Prisoners that actually oversees the distribution of this money, and there is its counterpart in the civilian sector known as the Prisoners Club. Now, this money constitute some of the best salaries in the Palestinian Authority. So you can literally go from poverty to wealth in the Palestinian Authority by committing an act of terrorism. This amounts to about 6% of the Palestinian budget. This money is paid on a priority basis. You can make as much as $3,000 or $4,000 a month while in prison just for committing this act of terrorism.
According to Black, some of the money can be tracked back to American taxpayers. The U.S. currently provides $400 million per year to the Palestinian Authority.
There's a law against any of our money benefiting terrorism, but in point of fact, approximately 6% of all the money we fund to the Palestinian Authority is proudly diverted by them to pay terrorist salaries. The money comes, it goes right to the prisoner. The prisoner signs a POA, a power of attorney. He transmits that money to his bank account, to his lawyer, to his girlfriend, to his family, to his mother, to his organization. And this is a system that we have in place. Our State Department knows it. Our administration knows it.
In the wake of Abbas's deal with Hamas, Republican Senator Rand Paul introduced legislation that would cut funding to the Palestinian Authority. The Obama administration, however, plans to continue engaging the PA, meaning more terrorist salaries paid for in part by U.S. taxpayers.
They would rather starve than see their prisoners, who are their heroes, go without remuneration for the acts of violence that they have committed against innocent civilians, homes, buses, trains. It's an astonishment, and I think it's time for America to wake up.
Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News, Washington.